Hello, viewers. My name is Omoyele Sowore, and we are reaching you live from our New York City studios. And this time around, we are taking you to another country in Africa, Ivory Coast. As you all are aware, that's one country in West Africa that has been torn by civil strife for several years. But about a year and a half ago, the issues were resolved in a manner that further polarized the country. Today we have the opportunity of talking to Mr. Jean Gever Shede, who was the treasurer of the Popular Front Party, that is former President Laurent Gbagbo of Ivory Coast Party. We just want to hear from him what the situation is in his country. Mr. Shede, you're welcome to Sahara TV in New York City.
Well, thank you. Thank you very much.
Yes. Yeah, so you apparently are in Ivory Coast, reaching us and to talk about the current situation. What is the current situation politically in your country as of today?
Well, as today, the political situation is that the president, the former president, President Laurent Gbagbo, who for us has won the election, is still in detention in The Hague. And inside the country here, we have about 700 prisoners, political prisoners, but 14 of them have been released recently, 3 days ago, especially the president of the camp of our party, Front Populaire Ivoirien, we call FPI, the party which has been founded by Mr. Laurent Gbagbo himself. So at the moment, we are trying to convince the ruling people, the power, the government, to release all those prisoners because they have nothing to do there. There's nothing, there's no evidence against them, so we don't understand why they have been in prison for 2 years without any judgment at all. So we are still waiting for the government to go further than what they have done so far.
Let me ask you, is there any kind of discussions going on between the opposition party, that's yourselves, and the government? Is there a roundtable discussion on how to, you know, resolve all of this issue, or were you guys just left in the cold?
Yes, on the initiative of the President Gbagbo's party, we started a discussion, a roundtable, but the government broke it because they didn't want to understand, to hear any of our preoccupations. So we have to stop the discussion. We stopped them on March the 8th this year. So we are still waiting for them to resume those discussions because we know that without any discussion, you can't go anywhere unless you prefer the arms as a means of discussion.
Let me ask you, is there still any active conflicts on the ground? Do you still have people fighting and shooting in Ivory Coast right now? Everything is generally peaceful.
No, there's no such thing at the moment. The fighting has stopped. The crisis lasted, it took two or 3 months in 2011, and then it was over. What we see now is from time to time, some attacks on roads or some attacks of some military in some small villages, killing people, raping, locking, and all those things. But apart from that, there's no shooting in the country. There's no fighting in the country as such.
So the capital, Abidjan, is back to the peaceful place it used to be before. I mean, relatively.
We can say so.
All right.
We can say so.
All right.
Relatively.
So tell us about Laurent Gbagbo, that's the former president who is currently at The Hague. Recently, there was a ruling by the prosecutor's office that they so far don't have enough evidence to try him. So if they don't have enough evidence, why are they still keeping him in The Hague?
We are asking ourselves the same question, because the rule, the normal thing to do when you keep somebody in prison, and that you acknowledge yourself that there's no enough evidence to keep him in prison, the first thing to do is to release him. Even if you want to pursue your investigation to find more evidence, but you can give him, he can be paroled or something like this, you see? But we don't understand why Mr. Gbagbo is still in prison. Or if you want, we understand, because it is a political prisoner.
Oh, wow. So also his wife is still in detention, apparently.
Yeah, she is. Since 2011, April, she is still in detention in the north of the country.
Yes. One thing that they accuse former President Gbagbo of is that, you know, he was just in transition. He had been in power, you know, for two terms, and he didn't need to stick to wanting to be in power in a country where, you know, there is a lot of political tension on a level of, you know, ethnicity and regional tension. You know, why did former President Gbagbo refuse to leave power, you know, when it was obvious that maybe for political expediency or even peaceful purposes, his sitting power or creating a government of national unity would have prevented all of this crisis from happening?
Well, the propaganda tends to present Mr. Gbagbo as somebody as a dictator who didn't win the election and want to leave the power. No, the thing is that we only have two elections in this country since Mr. Gbagbo came. The first one was in 2001 against General Guy Robert. And 2 years after he's taking power, Mr. Soro Kyom and his rebellion attacked the country. And we have been dealing with this problem for 8 years until Mr. Gbagbo himself accepted to discuss directly with the rebellion, and then we went to those elections of 2010. Now, if you win the election, and the Constitutional Council, who is the only entity to say who has won or not, if they say that you have won, what do you do? You say that my opponent says no, so I abandon? No. In democracy, we have the French system in Côte d'Ivoire here. We have the Constitutional Council, who is in charge of giving the results and telling who of the candidates has won the election. And this is what has been done properly, normally. And then Mr. Alassane Ouattara said, no, I am the winner. And we said, okay, the only person who can say who is the winner is the Constitutional Council. He says that Mr. Gbagbo is the winner. How come you say that you are the winner? And there, well, this is what, how all those battles for the presidency started. And there was a war. The French soldiers and the UN soldiers bombed the residence of the official residence of the president. They took him and they gave him to Mr. Alassane Ouattara. This is all. So we, in Côte d'Ivoire, in Ivory Coast, we don't understand all this propaganda which is going on all the world. But we know that one day the truth will come out. One day.
Yes. Maybe. So, where's Mr. Soro now, the rebel leader at that time? Where is he now?
He is now in the party of Mr. Alassane Ouattara. He is the president of the National Assembly, the equivalent of the Congress in America or something like that. You see, he was the prime minister chosen by Mr. Gbagbo for reconciliation. He was the one who organized the election, and then after the coup, because for us in the Mr. Gbagbo's camp, we consider that this is a coup. After overthrowing Mr. Gbagbo, he became the prime minister of Mr. Hassan, and then he's now the president of the National Assembly.
Wow. So one of the things that came out of this is the role of the French government in the crisis. So apparently, a lot of the French West African countries are still under direct control of the French government. And Mr. Gbagbo did not change that when he was in power. He continued to be an appendage of the French government. He didn't. So the French had the power to just intervene whenever they want. When do you think West African French countries will stop this kind of military relationship with France that allows France to just come in and do whatever they like?
Well, I agree with you that we have a strong oppression of the French government, because we used to be a French colony. Nigeria used to be a British colony, and so on and so forth. The thing is, if you consider the power of all those countries, and if you consider the power of the African countries, there's no comparison. So we were trying, when Mr. Gbagbo came in power, we were trying to reduce the influence of the French government over the African government. That is what Mr. Gbagbo is paying now, being in detention. Everybody knows that in Africa. And I'm very happy to hear the African Union now realizing that time has come, that African, the stand up for their rights, the stand up for their dignity, and to try to withdraw from this oppression which is held by the French government. But we are trying, because you can struggle. You have to struggle as a man. You can lose sometimes, but you can win sometimes. But one day will come, if not you, your child or the child of your child will win. And we have confidence in that.
Yes.
It is a long way to
go. So let me quickly ask you, if Mr. Gbagbo were to be released and returns to Ivory Coast today, will he continue to lay claim to his presidency, or will he just retire and go and just lead his party again? Well, what is the plan, supposing he returns and his wife is released and all his former party operatives are allowed out of prison? What would be the next plan for your group?
Well, I'm not in a position to tell you the next plan of Mr. Gbagbo. He is in prison and we have not been in contact with him, and he didn't tell us what he is going to do. We are trying, we are struggling for him to come out. When he comes out, he'll tell us what he wants to do. But we believe that being in power is not the aim. The object, the purpose of our struggle is to liberate our Africa. No matter who is in power, provided that the person rules the country in a way that one day we can have our real independence. This is what is important.
Yes. So one of the last thing I will ask you, of course, is, have you guys been allowed to participate in elections or any political activity? Are you openly allowed to organize as a political party?
We tried, but the present government refused to let us participate to the local election or to the general elections. We couldn't. It was not possible. First thing, most of our leaders are in prison. Some have come out now. 10 or 12 of them have come out, but we still have about 200 who are in prison or in exile. Second, the commission which is in charge of organizing the election is controlled 100% by the government. We cannot participate. So they refuse everything, and our houses, our bank accounts, everything is in the hands of the government. We cannot even go to the bank and withdraw money for ourselves.
Wow. Well, Mr. Shede, I want to thank you for coming on Sahara TV. Unfortunately, we don't have more time, but you trust that we'll keep checking in with you to see what's happening in your country, Ivory Coast. And I wish you well and safe as you continue to organize yourselves politically. Keep in touch, and we'll love to have you back and hear more from you. Thank you so much
for
coming on our show.
Thank you, my brother. Right. Thank you, brother. Thank you.
Viewers, that's been Mr. Jean Govey Shede. He's a former treasurer of Popular Front Party. That was a party of former President Laurent Gbagbo, who is currently in The Hague facing, according to him, actually not any crimes at this point, but they are looking for more evidence to nail him if they can find it. So please do not go away. There's more to come on Sahara TV today. And don't forget, it's the 100th show of Dr. Damages. So I also want to wish Dr. Damages happy anniversary of his 100th show. And I heard that President Jonathan was on that show, so don't miss it.